Good morning, everyone. It's Tracy of Move Daily Fitness. If you're just joining this channel, well, welcome here. We are all about fitness, wellness, and nutrition, but doing it in such a way that you can sustain it for the rest of your life, not just for a week, not just for a month, but forever. All right, today's workout, we're gonna do a high intensity interval circuit. We're combining cardio moves with weight-based moves. So you're gonna need some dumbbells for this. I'm gonna use a variety. I've got between 5s and 15s. Grab whatever you have, and we're gonna get going. All right, let's ditch this sweatshirt and get started. Okay, so each exercise is gonna be for 45 seconds. I'll give you 15 seconds of reprieve in between. I'll show you some modifications for some of the exercises as well. It'll give you time to grab your weights and grab water if you need in between. All right, let's start with a warm up here. So feet are shoulder width apart. We're just gonna start with some squats. Just wanna get the body nice and warm before we begin this high intensity circuit here because, well, it's gonna be work for the body. So let's just put it that way. Let's get things warmed up. Okay, nice and wide. Take it to a plie. Oh, we just say I'm still sore there. I did a heavy leg workout the other day and I did some good weighted plie squats with a really heavy, I think it was a 45-pound plate. And now I'm sore, now I can't walk, so what are you gonna do? Okay, one in front, one behind, little pelvic tilt. We're going for 10 split squats here. So that's good. Anyway, hopefully you guys are all getting ready for Christmas decorations. Once this video is out, it's gonna be past Thanksgiving in the States. And switch legs here. I remember when we used to live in the States, we always set up our Christmas right after Thanksgiving there. So it was fun, cozy. I'm totally enjoying it here because it makes everything feel nice and warm and cozy. All right, let's have some high knees here. Just get the heart rate up. We're gonna go for 50, that's 10. 20, of course, you can just walk these out if you want. 30, 40, and 50. Okay, another round of that. Feet shoulder width apart and squat. Good job. Well, all the stores everywhere is making it feel like the holidays are ready, so why not? Because come December 26th, it's all coming down. Okay, nice and wide. Toes pointing out, and plie squat here. Good, five more. Keep your shoulders back nice and tall. Let those knees track out over your toes there. One more. Okay, split squat. One in front, one behind. Pelvic tilt. Drop it for 10. Make sure you're pushing through the heel to come back up. Five more here. All right, switch sides and drop. Halfway. Three, two. All right, let's have some butt kicks this time for 50. Here we go. Kick your butt. Modify by just tapping it back there. That's 10. 20, 30, 40, and 50. Okay, one more round here. Back to the squats. I like this warm up. It gets the legs warmed up, but also gets the blood flowing with the heart rate. So always for my clients, this is a typical warm up. All right, nice and wide. Kind of gives you all aspects of the legs and gets the blood flowing to upper body parts. All right, five more here. Good, one in front, one behind. Pelvic tilt and drop for 10. And switch legs, last 10 right here. Here we go for 10. 3. And there's 10. All right, let's have cardio kicks for 50. Foot comes in front, you can modify right here or jump it up right here. 10. 20. 30. 40. And 50. Okay, good. We're gonna start with weights. I've got my timer set, 45 seconds of work, 15 seconds of rest. Grab your heavier dumbbell and let's get started. All right, we're gonna start with the pendulum swing. You're gonna hold a weight in your hand, lunge forward. The weight is gonna be in the opposite knee that you are lunging forward with. Switch the weight, lunge reverse. Okay, forward and reverse. All right, you're 45 seconds per side here. So let's get started. We've got a long way to go. Stay super tall. Of course, to modify, you can do this without a weight. We're really gonna burn out that one leg though. This is gonna be good cardio too, just because it's so rapid. And you're staying on that same leg the full 45 seconds. Good, you're almost there. Last 5 seconds here. All right, shake that side out. Whew. One side isolated like that, really feel it. All right, other leg is stationary this time. Start super tall. I'm gonna start with a reverse lunge in 3, 2, here we go. That front lunge is hard. You really have to work on pushing through the heel. Straight back up. Almost there. Woo. No sense in starting easy, hey guys? Wowza. Okay, cross body jacks coming up. Modify right here. Otherwise, we're jumping it. Jumping jack, crossing feet, crossing hands. Here we go. Halfway. Three, two, and rest. Okay, let's do an upper body one to bring heart rate down a bit. I'm gonna grab my eights for a bicep curl. Palms are up, all the way down. Ready? Full range of motion here. Knees are soft, tummy tucked in tight, and keep your elbows tucked in close to your sides here. Good job. Shoulders back. So your tendency here would be to start to swing at the bottom. Don't. Place them where they land at the bottom, and then use those biceps to lift them back up. Good. All right, a side lunge is coming up. I'm gonna hold one heavy weight in my hands. Of course, you can do no weight if you want or a lighter weight. I'm gonna grab my 115. So we're alternating lunges. So these side lunges right here and then alternating sides. reach your hips back as far as you can. Ready? Here we go. Alternate and reach. Good. It's still a squat, remember, hey? So that bent leg should be acting like a squat. Your hips should be reaching back like you would with a squat. The other leg stays straight. There, good. That's it. 10 more seconds here. We're gonna move into a cardio. All right, rest. Okay, so cardio, we're gonna do just a butt kick. So simple right there, we did that in our warm up. To modify, you'll just kick back right here. We're going in 3, 2, here we go. All right, keep this going at a nice steady pace here. Add those arms if you wish. I keep it a little bit wider. I just like how it feels on my hips that way. Do whatever you like. Halfway. Good job. Last 5 seconds here. In 3, 2, all right, whew, good. Grab your weights again. I'm gonna go with 8 pounds. We're gonna do a tricep kickback coming up. So hinging forward at the waist. You're kicking back for triceps, ready? Here we go. So same rules apply, no swinging. Nice neutral neck. Tight core, tight abs, and press. Good. Really flex at the top of that press here. Good, you only have 15 seconds left. Keep working. Then we'll let the arms go for a second. That's it. In 4, 3, 2, one more right here. Good. All right, grabbing my bigger weight. We're gonna do a squat to overhead press. I'm gonna squat it down, flip it over, press it to the ceiling. Here we go, squat, flip, press, that's it. Low, so on that squat, I don't want you just bending forward, I want you actually squatting down. Okay, so not like this, that's deadlift. We're squatting, get low, good. Allow that weight to pull you down into a good squat position there. And then adding a little shoulder with that overhead press. Watch your face on this one, please. Good. All right, mountain climbers are coming up here. So one more right here. All right, set that weight down. We'll get in mountain climber position. So to modify, just tap this one in alternating feet. Otherwise, you're running it in 3, 2, here we go. As I've said before, anything past 20 seconds is a long time to do on mountain climbers, but it's good, so let's just do it. No complaining, myself included. Halfway there. Woo, shoulders are feeling this. All right, good. Okay, moving into some deadlifts here. I'm gonna grab my heavier weights again. All right, we're gonna hinge forward at the waist, reach your hips back, and power back up. Ready? Here we go, so reaching, separating those glutes in the back because you're reaching back so far. And then boom, power them forward. That's right, I said boom. That was weird, but I'm doing it anyway. But that's what you have to think about with this exercise, is really reaching your hips back as far as they'll go and then extending the hips forward. That's what's propelling you back up. The hip action, the thrust. Okay, don't say thrust, Tracy. Just got weird. All right, keep going. Here we go. All right, full shoulder lateral raise coming up. So I'm gonna grab fives for that because 45 seconds is gonna be a long time. Full range of motion out to the side, all the way up, all the way down. In three, two, here we go. So palms face away from me on this one. Oh, I might regret the fives. Maybe should have grabbed eights. This is feeling pretty light, but hey, 45 seconds, it could fatigue out. I'm gonna hope for that. Next time I'll start heavier, because I can always lighten. Good. All right, you're halfway there. Try not to lean forward as they come down, okay? I just caught myself doing that, but stay tall. Whew, I'm feeling it, that's good. 10 seconds left. Last one here. Good. All right, let's move to our cardio again. Good, we're gonna do some fast feet. I don't love it either, but let's go fast feet into a flat plank on the stomach. So here's a modification of that. Five, four, three, two, one. Walk it out, walk it back up, and start again. So watch for this first one if you don't get it. So fast feet, three, two, one, and then down. Good, five, four, three, two, one, and down. Five, four, three, two, one, and down. Five, four, three, two, one, go. Five, four, three, two, one. Five, four, three, two, one. One, five, four, three, two, one. Five, okay, good. Okay, coming up next, you're doing a suitcase squat. Hold heavy weights by your sides. I have 215s. You're squatting straight up and down, pushing through the heels. All right, let's start in five, four, three, two, and here we go. The name of the game here is to stay tall. Don't bend over, okay? So, side view, you can see how tall my chest is. This would be wrong here, okay? Stay tall, drop your butt down. That's it. Think of those knees externally rotating at the bottom. And then again, thrusting the hips forward to propel yourself back to standing. All right, good. Let's grab our lighter weights again. Going back to another shoulder exercise, we're gonna do a full range of motion all the way to the ceiling, all the way down. Knees are soft. Ready? Here we go. Up and down. This does not have to be fast. Especially on the down, you want to control. All right? Good. Big stretch at the top. See how controlled and slow I am on this exercise. You're halfway through. I was gonna pick eights, I have fives. Without taking much of a break, this feels like it's already work, so I'm good with this weight. 5 seconds. And time. Okay, you're gonna do a big cardio coming up. And then we're gonna take a 45 second break, just to bring the heart rate down a little bit. All right, ice skaters with a giant hop each side, ready? Here we go. Here, and then big hop. Okay, modify this by just staying right here with the touch and without that big hop. Otherwise, jump it up, girls. And maybe one or two token boys. Hey, if you're a boy and you're watching this, comment below, because I'd love to see if a boy got this far in this workout. Good job. Not that you couldn't, but I just am curious. All right, you only 15 seconds left. Pick up your pace, boom, up and over. Come on, because remember, you're getting a big break after this. Let's go, let's go. 4, 3, 2, 1. Okay, that was hard. All right, so take a break. Grab water if you need. Extra 45 seconds here. You're still in break. Woo. All right. Coming up, we're gonna do another leg. You're gonna do a reverse lunge high kick. Okay, like that. We're gonna do 45 seconds per side. That is totally gonna burn up that leg. So work on bringing your heart rate down. It goes by fast. We literally have 10 seconds more rest, that's it. All right, I'm gonna grab my eights for this one. Reverse lunge high kick coming up. Make sure you have room. Ready? All right, here we go. Same leg is working, and you will feel this by the end. Halfway there. Drop it down, drop that back knee. Drop. Okay, don't just reach back. 10 seconds. Oh my. All right, rest for 15 seconds. Oh, that felt like work. Switching legs, get ready. Make sure there's room behind you. In 3, 2, here we go. Reverse kick. Whoops. A little tippy sometimes. A good trick or tip for that is to pick a spot in front of you on the floor, stay focused on that spot, and kick. Halfway there. Tricep move coming up. We're gonna do some skull crushers, I think. All right, holy, that was work. Okay, grab a heavy weight for this, 15 pounds. Go heavier if you want, but 45 seconds is a long time. Ready? Ooh, here we go. Up and over the head. Elbows stay close to your head here. Press. Good. Ooh, it's getting heavy. Bring it down if you need for a reprieve. Pop it back up as soon as you can. 10 seconds. On this one, it looks like my blood kind of is rushing from my arms. I think that's what feels yucky. Last one. Ooh. Job. Cardio, we're doing an oblique frog squat. So you're gonna be up like this, modify right here without the hop. Right like that. Ready? Do it. over half. Come on, drop those glutes. You're not just bending over here, remember. We're gonna add a little hamstring coming up here. Last one. Okay. Single leg extension. We're coming down and up. I'm gonna grab my 15 for this. And I'm adding a bicep curl at the top, okay? Ready? Here we go. Hinge, curl. And up. Good. Slow on this guy. Don't want to be quick. You've got 45 seconds per side, so take your time. That's it. You're aiming to bring your heart rate down a bit here too. So nice slow breathing. And reach that hip back. Good. All right, switch sides. All right, nice tight, tall back, hinging at the waist. It's a hinge, not a squat. Here we go. Hinge and curl. Keep your abs engaged before you curl that dumbbell up. Squeeze, reach, and up. One more. Good, okay. Let's blast those biceps out. Grab your matching weight. Let's knock out some hammer curls. All right, heavyweight hammers, ready? Here we go. Curl, squeeze at the top. Whew, that one side that I just did not get enough break, did it? Owie, I'm gonna keep going though. And then I'll give us a longer break next, okay? See, there's that push until you can't, rest until you can method. Challenge yourself until you need that break. Take a break, and as soon as you can do it again, get back in the game. Whew, good. Okay, longer break here. Grab some water. Coming up next, we're gonna be doing an alternating curtsy lunge with a lateral raise, okay? So as you descend, lateral raise comes up and squeeze those delts. Ready? Here we go. Okay, so you're here together and curtsy. So with the curtsy, you wanna make sure that your body's facing forward. Okay, you don't wanna just rotate everything and turn like that. Body faces forward, leg comes behind diagonal. All right, good. Okay, if arms are fatiguing and you're like, oh my gosh, I'm dying, keep the legs going. Bring the arms right here. For a little rest, add them back in when you can. Good. Only 10 seconds. All right, that's it. Good job. We're gonna do a little predator jack coming up. So you're wide together, wide. Otherwise you're jumping it out in 4, 3, 2, here we go. That's it. Keep dropping those glutes nice and low. All halfway there. Five seconds. Oh, okay. Breathe. Tricep kickouts. I'm grabbing my fives for this. Elbows are coming high. We're kicking those dumbbells out. Ready? Here we go. Out and squeeze. Good press and flex at the top of that. If I had grabbed my eights, I wouldn't be able to do this. My arms are burning. 10 seconds. One more. Let's take it down to the ground, okay? A little leg work down here. We're gonna do a single leg glute bridge. I'm actually gonna get you just to do 20 seconds on one side, 20 on the other. Foot to the ceiling, other foot close to your bottom. Press it up, here we go. You can make this heavier by putting a dumbbell, a plate, or a bar on your hips. All right, that is definitely an option for you. Press to the ceiling. One more here, now switch your legs. And push. Good. Press through the glutes there. We'll stay down here. We're going to go into an ab exercise coming up. Keep pushing. One more right there. All right. You're doing a sweeping V-sit right here. Okay, so pretend like there's a cone or dumbbell right there in front of you. Press side to side. So getting a little oblique in here as well. And crunch, right there. Good, bum stay still. Rotate those heels up slightly, and then you'll hit those obliques. Good. Whew, 20 seconds. Four, three, two, and one. All right, let's stay down here for some partial burpees because those are always fun and hard and brutal. Modify right here by tapping your foot up to your hand. Otherwise, we're jumping. Ready? Here we go. Jump forward, back into a plank. That was a long time. It was really hard. Okay, staying down here. Let's go into a renegade row. Heavy dumbbell, plank position. Row it up. Ready? Here we go. Row, alternate hands. Row. Left. guys. Stay down here. Let's go for a Russian twist. I'm gonna grab a little bit of a lighter weight, maybe my 8. We'll knock these out. Last exercise. Here we go. Now, modify this by no weight and just leaning back, okay? Otherwise, grabbing that weight, lifting your legs up if you can. Slow on this one though. Oh, break if you need. Halfway through. Oh my, sorry. Keep going. All right, oh, that's it. Let's move into a good stretch. All right, let's just sit down nice and tall. Hinge forward at the waist, one leg is out, one knee is bent, and just hold that right there. Hey, if you made it to the end of this video, congratulations. I found that hard. I don't know about you, but that was definitely work. My heart is still ticking, but you know, something like a post-vacation, post-Thanksgiving, post-overeating Christmas workout like that actually just makes you feel like you're right back in the swing of things, right? I feel like it makes me feel powerful, makes me feel strong, and makes me believe that my body can do something like that. And that gives me an increased sense of self-efficacy. Self-efficacy. That's the belief that you can do something, that you can achieve something. And the more we can participate in exercises that increase our self-efficacy, the more time we're gonna spend devoted to the task. The more time you spend devoted to the task, the more shift and change you'll see. And that's really how living a fit life is done. All right, let's just press those knees down to the side there. That's good. You know, I watch a lot of YouTube videos and similar content to mine, lots of fitness ones. And one thing that really bothers me, that really disturbs me, is the amount of content, let's bring our arm across here, that's out there that says that you can achieve fat loss on your arms, a bigger butt, toned abs in 5 days, in 30 minutes, in 6 weeks. I know what they're trying to do. They're trying to get views because we all want the quick fix. Like, who wants to hear that it's actually hard work of diet and exercise for the rest of your life? Who wants to hear that? That's hard. That's work. But you know what? That's what I want, is just to be honest with you all about what it takes to stay in shape, to be fit. And it is a lot of work, it's a lot of dedication. But here's a good tip. What I find with clients who have succeeded, who have done well in this regard, let's bring our arms across, push up, is you make it routine. It's part of your life, it's part of your journey, it's part of your schedule. It's non-negotiable. It's not that you should just, I should do it, I should work out, I should exercise, I should eat healthier. It's that you must. You must work out in order to increase your longevity. You must eat healthy in order to nourish your body and live your best life. So I think turning some of those shoulds into musts are a good way to start to reframe the whole thought of being healthy for the rest of your life. All right, great job. I'm parched, I need water. Oh, and just like that, water has arrived. All right, thanks for joining, you guys. Make sure that you click subscribe and also click that little bell right beside subscribe, because that gives you indicators. It'll show up on your phone and you can go, oh, hey, there's a new workout out. I'm gonna do that on Saturday morning. All right, make sure you plan it, because when you do that, you're gonna be successful in your endeavors. All right, go move daily.